Hey, this is Ago, and in this video, I want to address a question that I get asked all the time. Ago, how do I know I'll be successful at selling B2B services? When it comes to selling B2B services, a lot of my coaching and training clients ask me, Ago, how do I know I'll be successful at this? How do I know I can make this happen? Now, sometimes they're early on in their career and they have questions like that. Sometimes they made a transition out of maybe more of a consulting role and they wonder about the same thing. Whatever the case may be, being successful at selling B2B services is something that they really want, they really strive for, and they want to accomplish. So in this video, I'm going to give you five characteristics that I've seen universally with folks, with people who are successful at selling B2B services at a high level to senior executives and mid-level managers in large and mid-sized corporations. And the first thing, the first criterion for success, the first key to success, if you will, is you need to have the mindset of a consultant, not a seller. Especially in today's post-recession, post-2008 world, you really need to be out there educating, providing thought leadership, helping your client decide which option is best for them, but not in a pushy way, but very much in a collaborative way where you take the position of a trusted outside advisor, trusted counselor, if you will, with your clients. The second key success factor that I see is people who are successful at selling high-end B2B services, they really think buyer-centric, or they really think buyer first. They're always wondering, what is the best outcome for my client, for my prospect? They're not thinking about their product or their service until a much later stage in the sales process, when they clearly understand which needs their buyer have, which desires they have, desired outcomes or objectives, what they value, what the risks are. And only then do they position their offering against what a client might want. The third key success factor is successful B2B sellers take a long-term strategic perspective, not a short-term tactical one. What that means is they're not just focused on the next sale or the next deal or bringing in this particular client. They're always thinking about what happens 2-3 steps down the road. So kind of like chess players, they think about a single deal as a first stepping stone. And then think about the next one, and then think about the one after that. What can I do to put in place a foundation that will build a long-term relationship with this client, a long-term relationship with this firm? The fourth key success factor that I see with those who are successful at selling B2B services is they exhibit an attitude of collaboration, not confrontation. In other words, they really see themselves as a value-added or a value-adding partner in the sales process, and they walk alongside their client every step of the way, never pushing too much, just enough, I would say, but always thinking in terms of collaboration. How can we do this together? It's not you versus me, it's really us versus the problem or the situation. And then the fifth key that I see with those who are successful in selling high-end B2B services are they lead with new insights, ideas, and perspectives. In other words, they don't really talk about their products often very much at all. They talk about the results those products can achieve, the challenges that the product can overcome or the service can overcome. They talk about the outcomes that the client is seeking and how they can accomplish those or how they can help the client achieve those. Those are the things they talk about. Now, I think in recap, the most important point is this. Think of yourself, if you want to be successful at selling B2B services, think of yourself as a consultant, not a seller. Think of yourself as a trusted ally, a value-added advisor, someone who is there to advise your client or your prospect on the best course of action to take moving forward. And if you really take a long-term perspective, sometimes that may even mean that you don't want this deal. You don't want to work with this particular client because you know it'll be better for them and for you in the long run. If you like this video, as always, subscribe to my YouTube channel. I hope to see you soon. Thank you.